Hi, how are you going? I hope you're feeling as well as possible on your medicines. I'm Pharmacist Fi, and this is Denver. Welcome to our Medicine Safety YouTube channel and to this special edition video to let you know that in December 2022, the European Medicines Agency's Safety Committee has just recommended banning medicines which have the active ingredient pholcodine in them. And later in this video, I will explain why this means that before you have any surgery under general anaesthesia, you should tell your surgeon and your anaesthetist if you think you may have taken any products with pholcodine in them in the past 12 months. Pholcodine has been marketed for use for a dry, non-productive cough, either being sold as the only active ingredient in things like syrups or capsules, or in combination with other products to reduce cold and flu symptoms. The Federal Drug Agency in the United States of America refused to allow pholcodine to be sold in the USA some time ago, but products with pholcodine in them are still available in quite a few countries. Just in case you're wondering, pholcodine is different to codeine. So the research that I'm talking about in this video only applies to pholcodine. So why has the European Medicines Agency just recommended banning pholcodine in Europe? Interestingly, the structure of pholcodine is similar to a section of some medicines called neuromuscular blocking agents, which are used to prevent our body from moving while we are under general anaesthesia for surgery. And in case you're wondering, general anaesthesia is the type of anaesthesia where we are not awake during the surgery. Now, why does it matter that pholcodine and neuromuscular blocking agents have a similar shape in part of their structure? The immune systems of some people who take pholcodine create an antibody to pholcodine, which does not cause symptoms at the time when they are taking pholcodine. But this IgE antibody to pholcodine may also bind to a similar section on neuromuscular blocking agents, and this increases the risk of having an anaphylactic reaction to the neuromuscular blocking agent during surgery, especially if that person has taken pholcodine during the past 12 months before the surgery. And in case you're wondering, an anaphylactic reaction is a severe allergic reaction, which may have potentially life-threatening symptoms. So, how common is anaphylaxis during surgery with general anaesthesia? Some recent research in France called the ALFO study, which is the main reason the European Medicines Agency recommends banning pholcodine in Europe, that ALFO study reports that on average, for every 10,000 people having surgery with general anaesthesia, about 1.84 of those people will get anaphylaxis. But if people have taken pholcodine within the 12 months before their surgery, their anaphylaxis risk may become about 4.2 times higher, which raises the risk to about 7.7 people getting anaphylaxis per 10,000 people having surgery with general anaesthesia. Based on this info, the rate of anaphylaxis during surgery is still low, but if it is possible to make the risk of anaphylaxis about 4 times lower by not using pholcodine, I think that sounds like something we should all consider if we live in countries where pholcodine is still currently available, like here in Australia or the UK. If you are going to have surgery under general anaesthesia and you think you may have taken a product with pholcodine in it during the past year before the surgery, make sure you tell your surgeon and your anaesthetist so that they can be extra careful to watch for any possible signs of anaphylaxis during surgery, so that if anaphylaxis did happen, they could treat it as soon as possible, which is very important. If you are interested in a bit more of the science behind the info we have just talked about, I will put some links to some research into the description section below this video for you. Please click the subscribe and like buttons below this video if you'd like to see more of these medicine safety videos. And Denver and I look forward to catching up with you again very soon here on this Pharmacist Fi Medicine Safety YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. Bye.